it's not so rare. If you look at it carefully, you see that there's millions of people all over Europe that suffer from some kind of dystonia, but the degree of severity is ranging from one subject to another one. So people sometimes have subtle problems, like subtle movements, problems with speech, with facial movements or with hand movements, positions, changes of their neck, and these go unrecognized for long periods of time, even when it causes distress or pain for patients.